Welcome to this session of our Pharma Industry Trends discussion series of METTLER TOLEDO. My name is Cornelia Schneider. I am a business development manager for Europe with segment knowledge in pharma as well as discrete manufacturing. And I am working in the weighing industry with METTLER TOLEDO for 7 years now. I'd like to welcome Vanessa Doudloff as our panelist today.
Thanks for having me, Cornelia. My name is Vanessa Doudloff, and I'm working for METTLER TOLEDO for more than 7 years now, being a product manager for floor scales.
So today we will be discussing the importance of hygienic requirements in the pharma industry. Our panelist Vanessa will explore the latest guidelines and standards for ensuring product safety and quality through rigorous hygienic practices. We will examine how the pharma industry is adapting to new challenges and how hygienic requirements are evolving to meet these challenges. Join us for an informative and thought-provoking discussion on this critical topic. Vanessa, how are hygiene practices and requirements evolving in response to the COVID-19 pandemic, and what impact is this having on pharma manufacturing processes?
Okay, so the COVID-19 pandemic has brought renewed attention to hygiene practices and requirements in the pharmaceutical industry. So companies are taking additional measures to ensure safety and health. So personal protective equipment, such as masks and cloths, and enhanced cleaning and disinfection procedures for the manufacturing equipment and facilities have been implemented. And companies really try to balance the need to maintain high levels of hygiene with the need to ensure efficient and also cost-effective manufacturing processes. And some of the companies even started to explore the use of new technologies and automation to reduce the need for physical contact and enhance the safety of their employees, obviously.
Indeed. So the challenge for the pharmaceutical industry during this phase can be clearly pictured. What are the current guidelines and standards for ensuring product safety and quality, especially through these rigorous hygienic practices? And how are pharma companies working to meet these requirements?
So basically, there are several guidelines and standards that aim to ensure the safety and also the quality of pharmaceutical products. For example, the FDA, through the Good Manufacturing Practice regulations, underline the need for effective cleaning processes. But GMP really also covers a wide range of areas, including personnel, equipment, facilities, materials, and quality control procedures. And then we have the ISO standards covering areas such as quality management, environmental management, and occupational health and safety. In addition, there is EHATCH and also the NSF International. Those are like really good experts in good design practice for sanitary equipment. So also like a very important aspect.
Mm-hmm. So I understand there are several guidelines and standards to follow. So how can pharma companies also ensure that their suppliers and vendors are maintaining the same high levels of hygiene?
Yeah, so ensuring that suppliers and vendors maintain the same high levels of hygiene is a very important aspect of pharmaceutical quality management. Pharma companies can, for example, audit their suppliers and vendors to ensure that they are basically meeting like the same standards of hygiene that the company itself adheres to. And in addition, pharma companies can also require suppliers to provide certifications of products, like the equipment they are delivering, or implementing like real supplier quality agreements would also be another option.
Vanessa, can you give some examples how a supplier like METTLER TOLEDO meets standards of hygiene of their products for the pharmaceutical industry?
Sure. So first of all, when we develop a new product, we look at the market and evaluate if there are any specific requirements of our key segments, such as pharma, obviously. And those requirements can be really related to the material being used. So for example, some pharma customers really require that all the equipment they have in their facilities are made of a 316 stainless steel. And in some cases, it's more about the surface finish of products, for example, like scales. So they have to be less than 1 micrometer to prevent the accumulation of microorganisms. And then, of course, it's about hygienic design or maybe even like specific approvals that might be required. And in our case of METTLER TOLEDO, so once R&D starts with the product design, they adhere to hygienic design guidelines. So weighing equipment should really always prevent contamination of the manufactured products and facilitate easy cleaning.
Okay, so it seems there are quite a few manufacturing requirements. Do you have a specific product example?
Yes, I do. So our new PhD 779 lift low profile scale we recently launched has a fully sealed bottom plate without any cavities or crevices. And we have hermetically sealed load cells with IP68-69K protection to eliminate the risk of water or dirt ingress. And with the open frame design and with rounded edges and minimal flat surfaces, we help to ensure that every corner of the scale can be easily sanitized and you can visually inspect 100% of the scale to maintain compliance and reduce any kind of risk of contamination. And at the end of this product development phase, we can basically, as a company, decide if we want to apply for a specific product certification to prove the hygienic design and kind of the values of a new product.
Okay, and what certifications of products do you provide them?
It depends on the product. So we have many different products. And for some products, we do have the EHEC or GMP certificate. So the PhD 779 lift I just mentioned before won the 2024 EHEC Hygienic Design Award in France. And in addition, the product is also certified by the Fraunhofer Institute to meet the highest standards of quality, safety, and hygiene.
And how do hygiene requirements in the pharma industry differ from other industries?
Yeah, so in the pharma industry, there are often very strict requirements for cleaning and sanitation to prevent contamination of products. I mean, obviously, it can also be dangerous if products are contaminated, especially for elder people when they get like medicine. In addition, sometimes it really requires the use of specialized facilities such as clean rooms to ensure that products are not exposed to contaminants. And there is often a greater emphasis on personnel hygiene, so a lot of hand washing and wearing protective clothing, as employees can obviously also be a source of contaminant too. And another key difference are the more rigorous like quality control measures to ensure like product quality and safety.
And one last question. How does the design of METTLER TOLEDO products especially help in these environments then?
So METTLER TOLEDO really specializes in hygienic weighing solutions that are designed to exceed traditional industry standards in hygienic environments. We have hygienically designed product groups such as weigh modules, we have bench scales, we have floor scales, and many other products. And all of those products are constructed with no crevices or niches, with more rounded elements, because if you have like a lot of flat surfaces, it's easier for like water or bacteria to accumulate. And another key aspect is also like the corners and angles of the products. as well as, like, for example, smooth continuous wells and the absence of dead spaces. And additionally, as I said before, so some of our products are certified to really, like, emphasis on this hygienic design.
Okay, so thank you, Vanessa, for this informative discussion. So as a summary, hygienic requirements do help to prevent contamination and maintain the quality throughout the complete manufacturing process. And METTLER TOLEDO's focus on hygienic requirements makes them a key player in the pharma industry, helping manufacturers to ensure the safety and effectiveness of their products while meeting regulatory requirements. And this brings us to the end of today's podcast about the importance of hygienic requirements in the pharma industry. Stay tuned for the next session of our Pharma Industry Trends Discussion Series. Thank you.